Hello, I'm Givannaki Fedra. As you can see on the screen, our topic today is optimization of the graphene reinforcement in cement-based materials. This work is a collaboration between Aegean University, Betakai Systems, and Eastern Macedonian Thrace Institute of Technology. Let me start with some general information. A composite material is a material made from two or more constituent materials with significantly different mechanical or chemical properties that, when combined, produce a material with characteristics different from the individual components. In mechanics, multiscale modeling is aimed to calculation of material properties or system behavior on one level using information or models from different levels. On each level, particular approaches are used for the description of a system. One way to calculate and predict the effective properties of heterogeneous material is using analytical methods. The most important analytical methods are the theoretical bounds of Hill-Reuss-Voigt, the asymptotic Hassin-Strickland bounds, the SLB model, the Mori-Tanaka model, and the multi-step homogenization method. During the last years, the production of multi-wall carbon nanotubes and graphene enabled the reinforcement of the composite materials at the nanoscale. To this end, a methodology to identify the optimum material synthesis needs to be effectively addressed. The present article presents an optimization method to quantify the appropriate volume fraction of graphene nanostructures at cement-based nanocomposite with a target value of the effective modulus. The IP-OPT algorithm is used for the optimization iterations applied to the homogenization properties calculated by ANSA preprocessor. Turning our attention now to the methodology. The steps to be followed for the optimum volume fraction identification using the present method are: first, the target effective modulus of the homogenized material and the boundaries for the volume fraction need to be set. Afterwards, an initial point for the IP-OPT algorithm needs to be chosen. The initial point is the initial value of the carbon nanotube volume fraction. Then, given the carbon nanotube and the matrix modulus and Poisson ratio, and the initial volume fraction, the effective modulus of the homogenized material is calculated. The calculation is achieved using the multi-step method combined with RVE method at ANSA preprocessor. As next step, the difference between the target effective modulus and the calculated effective modulus of the homogenized material is evaluated. If the difference is less than 1 times 10 to minus 4, or the number of the completed iterations are less than 1000, move on to the next iteration. If not, convergence has been achieved. The following step is a new iteration of the algorithm. A next point for the IP-OPT algorithm is chosen. The next point is the new value of the carbon nanotube volume fraction. Afterwards, given the carbon nanotube and the matrix modulus and Poisson ratio and the new volume fraction, the effective modulus of the homogenized material is calculated. The calculation is achieved using the multi-step method combined with the RVE method at ANSA preprocessor. As we can see from the loop, the difference is evaluated for the new iteration and the loop keeps on until convergence is achieved. For the purposes of this research, the so-called periodic geometry algorithm was used. Periodicity across surfaces means that continuity between adjustment RVEs is ensured. This way, this is achieved by is that inclusion in the RVE that intersect the cube outer surfaces are cut with the remainder being placed as continuing from the opposite surfaces as in figure. Additionally, the algorithm takes into account a minimum separation distance between the surfaces of any two inclusions. A sophisticated method of fibers positioning that is used at the present research is random orientation tensor. With the application of the random orientation tensor, it becomes possible for each individual inclusion to have its own position and orientation. Each inclusion is positioned in space according to probability of convergence to x1, x2 and x3 axes. In order to achieve a higher randomization of inclusions positioning in the cube, the following values were used for the orientation tensor. A11, A22 and A33 were set at 0.33, with all other components left as null. In order to calculate the effective modulus, the composite is decomposed into grains, with each grain containing one inclusion family and the matrix. The inclusions in each family have the same material properties, aspect ratio, and orientation. In the first step, homogenization is performed in each grain using the Mori-Tanaka model. In the second step, the Voigt formulation is used to compute the properties of the overall composite. The effective modulus of elasticity is assumed as volume fraction dependent. The effective modulus is evaluated applying the multi-step method for an initial volume fraction. Thereafter, according to the objective value, a higher number of recalculation cycles are following. The objective function is the difference between the calculated and the target value of the effective modulus. At every cycle, a new volume fraction is set and a new objective is recalculated. The points X, which satisfy the constraints lower and upper bounds, are considered as feasible. Convergence is achieved when either the objective value is less than a specific value or a minimum number of iterations have been completed. All right, let's turn to data. At this slide, all material data that are used as given values at the optimization algorithm are displayed. Let's now turn to the results. At the present work, three cases of optimization were completed. First, an optimization case having as maximum number of iterations 20. Second, a case having as maximum number of iterations 200. And third, a case having as maximum number of iterations 1000. At this diagram, the calculated effective modulus versus iteration is displayed. The optimization parameters for this case are 20 maximum number of iterations and 5 megapascal maximum objective value. The final calculated volume fraction is 14.8 per mil and the calculated effective modulus is 4036 megapascal. This diagram shows the difference between the calculated effective modulus and the target effective modulus versus iteration. At this diagram, the calculated effective modulus versus iteration is displayed. The optimization parameters for this case are 200 maximum number of iterations and 1 megapascal maximum objective value. The final calculated volume fraction is 12.8 per mil and the calculated effective modulus is 4031.9 megapascal. This diagram shows the difference between the calculated effective modulus and the target effective modulus versus iteration. At this diagram, the calculated effective modulus versus iteration is displayed. The parameters for this case are 1000 maximum number of iterations and 1 time 10 to minus objective value. The final calculated volume fraction is 20 per mil and the calculated effective modulus is 4031.01 megapascal. This diagram shows the difference between the calculated effective modulus and the target effective modulus versus iteration. Now we come to the next point, which is the comparison. Selecting from each optimization case the calculated effective modulus and volume fraction and plotting them in two figures, we can easily make the following comparison. As we can see, the calculated effective modulus of the optimization case having 1000 iterations are really close to the target modulus. To conclude, as the table shows, in case the number of iterations is between 200 and 1000, the calculated modulus is close to 4031, which is the target modulus. Also, in case the number of iterations is between 200 and 1000, the deviation of the calculated effective modulus from the target effective modulus is less than 1 per mil. To sum up, according to the present methodology, the volume fraction required in order to attain a target effective modulus were successfully calculated. This methodology may be used for creating property tables for any composite of any number of materials and any number of inclusions geometric shapes. In case convergence is achieved after completing from 200 up to 1000 cycles, the accuracy of the calculated homogenized modulus is more than 91.1%.